Good morning, dear students. So as we have started the chapter percentage, so today we will discuss about percentage, how we can find out the number in percentage. So percentage means we have to understand that how much number we have gained in the hundred. What number in the hundred? So that we have to find out. In this chapter, we will see that how we can get the number. Suppose some number you have get in the exams. Suppose in the maths you have got 68 number. So if somebody will ask you that what percentage you have brought in the math exam, then how can you tell in the percentage? So that number should be including in the 100. Means in the 100 how much number? So we can find out that number by solving some questions. So first question is given here. Convert the following fraction in percentage. So some number is given, some fraction is given, and that fraction we have to change in the percent. So first question is given here. 80 by 100 is given here. So how we can change into the percent? So very simple it is. Only we have to multiply the 100 in that fraction. Then only we can get the percent of this number. So here 100, 100, it will cut easily. Then 80 is rest. Then we can say this is the percentage of the fraction 80 by 100. So the percentage of 80 by 100 is 80%. It means we can understand like this, that if in the math exam you have bought 80 number, and if we'll ask that how much percent, then because the total number of exam was 100, then you have got 80 number, then your percentage also will be in the 80%. Second question, one more question we'll see. Suppose it is given, one fraction is given, 68 by 100 is given. Then here also what we have to do, we have to multiply only 100 here. Then we'll see that 100 and 100 we can cut easily. Now the 68%. Like this we can solve this question. Whenever the question is asking convert the following fraction into percentage, then like this we can solve this question. Like we can find out the percent. So here 80 by 100, we multiply with the 100, then we find out that 80%. Same as 68 by 100 was given, this is fraction, then we multiply with the 100, then we get the 68%. Percent means that in 100, how much in 100? Like this we can solve. It's very easy to understand. The next question we'll see, that was question is given here. Another question is given, convert into percent through an equivalent fraction with 100 as denominator. So as we have studied the equivalent fraction also, and that another thing we have studied, that equivalent fraction, how we can find out equivalent fraction. So first I am going to tell you that how we was getting the equivalent number. So suppose 2 by 3 is given, then what will be the equivalent of 2 by 3? Then we have to multiply both the numerator and denominator with the same number. Then only we were getting that 2, 2 is 4 and 2, 3 is 6. Like this is getting. Here also we have to do that one question is, some fraction is given. Suppose one example we have to see, that 9 by 10 is given. And it is saying that first you have to do the denominator in 100. You have to change the denominator in 100. It means that, and another thing is saying that we have to make the equivalent fraction, we have to find out the equivalent fraction. So how we can do? So we have to think that in 10, how much we will multiply, then it will come 100. So here if you multiply 10 into 10, then it will come 100. And another thing we have to find out the equivalent. It means that numerator also we have to multiply with the 10. Then only we will get that 9 tens are 90 and 100, 10 tens are 100. Okay. So now we have find out the 90 by 100. This fraction here, this is the equivalent of 9 by 10. 90 by 100 is the equivalent number of 9 by 10. Now what we have to do? We have to find out the percent. So to find out the percent, what we have to do? We have to multiply with 100. And now easily we can cut this number 100, 100. So what number we'll find? now 90. Then this is some percent. It's very easy that we have to only denominator we have to find that how we can make it 100. So we have to find out that suitable number by that, but after multiplying that number we will find out the 100. So another exam we will see. Suppose it is here written 4 by, so another question, 4 by 5 is given. Then in the 5, what number we will multiply, then we will get the 100. So here it is very easy. If you multiply 20 in the 5, then we will get the 100. So it means we have to find out the equivalent. So we have to multiply with the 4 also. Then it will call the equivalent fraction we will find. So here 420, 80 and 520 is a 100. So the 80 by 100 is the equivalent of 4 by 5. Okay, so now we have to find out the percent. So what we'll do, we'll multiply this number with 100. So now 100, 100 and now 80 is there. Then it is percent. This will have answer. So like this we can find out very easy this fraction, equivalent fraction. So I think this question is also easy. Now another question we have to see, that it is written here, convert the following into percent by multiplying with 100. So fraction is given and that we have to multiply with the 100 and we have to find out the percent. So how we can, suppose we know, one example we will see now. Example is given, 8 by 9 is given and it is saying that we have to multiply with the 100. So now here we multiply with the 100. Okay, so here it, that 100 and 9 will not cut, so we will multiply. So what will come here, it will come 100 into 8 is equal to 800 by 9. Now we have to divide this number because here it is not a proper fraction, it is improper fraction, so we have to change in the decimal. So we will divide here. So 9 8 is 72. So here 8 and 0 will come. Then here again 9 8 is 72. Then 8 decimal 0. Then 8 again it will come 72. Then again here it will come 8. So same as it will go on 88.88. So we can write here 88.88 we can write, or we can write that 89. Whenever any number is going continuously the same number, then we can write one more number. So here we can write 88.88 or we can write 88.89. This will be our percentage. So like this we can, another example we will see. Another question is given, 9 by 14 and we have to just multiply with 100. It is already in the given in the question. So now we can write here 900 by 14. So we have to multiply this, divide with this number. So now we can divide here 14 by 14 divided 900. Okay. So now this number will multiply, then whatever number we will get, that will be our percent. So like this we can solve very easy. Because already it is saying that this fraction we have to multiply with 100. So it's very easy. Okay. Next, it is written here. Next question we'll see. That question is given, convert the following into percent. Four number we'll see. Convert the following into percent. So it is written in mixed fraction. 1 upon 1 2 by 5. 2 by 5. So first we have to write in the proper fraction 1 5. 1 5 is 5 and 5 plus 2. 6 7. So we can write 7 by 5. And now what we have to do? We have to multiply with 100. Then here we can cut 5 1 is 5. 5 to 20, it will come. Then 7 to the 14, then 140%. Like this we can solve very easy. Another question we'll see, another example we'll see. Mixed fraction is given 2 upon 3 by 4. Then first we have to change in the proper fraction. Then the 2 4 is 8 and 8 3 11, 11 by 4. Now 11 by 4, now what we have to do, we have to multiply with 100. Then now 4 1 is 4, not 2 4, 2 2 is 4, 2 5 is 10, 0. Then 2 1 is 2 and 2 2 is 4 and 2 5 is 10, 25. Then 11 and 25 is multiply here. 11 into 25. What number will come? Then we will multiply here 1 5 and 2, 1 5 and 2, then 5 6 7 and 2. Then 275% will come. So like this we have to multiply. So first we have to break in the fraction, then we have to multiply with 100, then we have whatever number it will cut, then that number we have to cut, then we have to multiply, the same number will come, that is our percent. So like this we can solve very easy. Okay, so it's very easy. The next 5 number question we have to see. In that question it is given in the point. So first we have to change the point in the fraction, then only we have to multiply with 100. So first we'll see. Example is given. Suppose it is given 5 number we have to solve. 2.5 is given. Then we have to change in the fraction. So we can write 225 by 10 we can write. And now we have to multiply with 100. So here, we will multiply this, 10 is raised here, then 25 and 10, so it will come 250%. This is our percent. So like this we can solve the questions. One more question we will see. Suppose it is given here 0.6, then we have to change in the fraction. So we can write here 6 by 10 we can write, and now we multiply with 100. So 0, 0. Then now 6 and 10 is rest. Then we will multiply this number 6 into 10. Then it will come 60%. So like this we can find out the percent whenever it is given in the decimal. So it's a very easy chapter. You can solve all the question very easily. I hope you have understood this chapter. If there is any question, any doubt, you call me and ask me. So for today, it is enough. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.